जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोद नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोद नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोद नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीर वनचारी, यमुना तीर वनचारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha, Rasa Bihari Radha, Rasa Bihari Radhe. Jaya Sita Ram Lakshmana Hanuman Sita Ram Lakshmana Hanuman Jaya Goranita 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 Jaya Goranita Prabhupada, 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 Jai Prabhupada.
Jai Om Vishnupada, Paramahamsa, Parivrajakacharya, Stotra, Shatashri, Srimad, His Divine Grace. Abhay Charanaravinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Iskon Bibhuti Founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Ki Jayom Vishnupada Paramahamsa Parivrajaka Acharya Stotra Shita Shri Srimad His Divine Grace Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Srila Prabhupada Ki Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Premchakho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shvasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Ki Srimad Bhagavat Mahapurana ki, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories, all glories, all glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya So today morning we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 9, Mother Yashoda Binds Lord Krishna, Text 21. You all can please repeat after me. Nayam sukhapo bhagavan Dehinam gopika sutaha Jnaninam chatma bhutanam Yatha bhaktim atamiha Nayam sukhapo bhagavan Dehinam gopika sutaha Jnaninam chatma bhutanam Yatha bhaktim tamiha Nayam sukhapo bhagavan Dehinam gopika sutaha Jnaninam chatma bhutanam Yatha bhakti matamiha Nayam sukhapo bhagavan देहि नाम गोपिका सुतः ज्ञानिनां चात्मभूतानां यथा भक्तिमतामिह नायं सुखापो भगवान् नायं सुखापो भगवान् देहिनां गोपिका सुतः ज्ञानिनां चात्मभूतानां यथा भक्तिं मतामिह नाहं सुखापो भगवान् देहिनां गोपिका सुतः ज्ञानिनां चात्मभूतानां यथा भक्तिं मतामिह माताजीस नायं सुखापो भगवान् देहिनां गोपिका सुतः ज्ञानिनां चात्मभूतानां यथा भक्तिम अतामिह वर्ड टू वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन ना नॉट अयम दिस सुखापह वेरी इजीली ऑब्टेनेबल और एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ हैप्पीनेस भगवान द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड देहिनाम of persons in the bodily concept of life, especially the karmis. Gopika Sutaha, Krishna, the son of Mother Yashoda. Krishna is the son of Vasudev, is called Vasudeva. And as the son of Mother Yashoda, he is known as Krishna. Jnaninam cha, and of the jnanis who try to be free from material contamination. Atma bhutanam, of self-sufficient yogis. Yatha, as bhaktimatam, of the devotees. Iha, in this world. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. Translation. The Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, the son of Mother Yashoda, is accessible to devotees engaged in spontaneous loving service. But he is not as easily accessible to mental speculators, to those striving for self-realization by severe austerities and penances, or to those who consider the body the same as the self. Purport. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as the son of Mother Yashoda, is very easily available to devotees, but not to tapasvis, yogis, jnanis, and others who have a bodily concept of life. Although they may sometimes be called Shanta Bhaktas, real bhakti begins with Dasyaras. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, ye yatha mam prapadyante tam satathaiva bhajamyaham mama vartmanu vartante manushyah partha sarvashah. As living entities surrender unto me, I reward them accordingly. Everyone follows my path in all respects. O son of Pritha, everyone is seeking Krishna, for he is the super soul of all individual souls. Everyone loves his body and wants to protect it because he is within the body as the soul. Everyone loves the soul because the soul is part and parcel of the super soul. Therefore, everyone is actually seeking to achieve happiness by reviving his relationship with the Super Soul. As the Lord says in Bhagavad Gita, Vedaischa Sarvair Ahameva Vedyaha. By all the Vedas, it is I who am to be known. Therefore, the Karmis, Jnanis, Yogis, and saintly persons are all seeking Krishna. But by following in the footsteps of devotees who are in a direct relationship with Krishna, especially the inhabitants of Vrindavan, who can reach the supreme position of associating with Krishna. As it is said, Vrindavanam parityajya padam ekam na gacchati. Krishna does not leave Vrindavan even for a moment. The Vrindavan Vasis, Mother Yashoda, Krishna's friend and Krishna's conjugal lovers, the younger gopis with whom he dances, have very intimate relationship with Krishna. And if one follows in the footsteps of these devotees, Krishna is available. Although the Nitya Siddha expansions of Krishna always remain with Krishna, if those engaged in sadhana siddhi follow in the footsteps of Krishna's Nitya Siddha associates, such sadhana siddhas also can easily attain Krishna without difficulty. But there are those who are attached to bodily concept of life. Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, for example, have very prestigious positions and thus they have the sense of being very exalted Ishwaras. In other words, because Lord Brahma and Shiva are guna avataras and have exalted positions, they have some small sense of being like Krishna. But the pure devotees who inhabit Vrindavan do not possess any bodily conception. They are fully dedicated to the service of the Lord in sublime affection. Prema. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has therefore recommended Prema Pumartho Mahan. The highest perfection of life is Prema. Pure love in relationship with Krishna. And Mother Yashoda appears to be the topmost devotee who have attained this perfection. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kada Mahyam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guroho Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamscha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Goratvishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dinabandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namosute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanusute Devi Pranamami Haripriye Vancha Kalpataru Bhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shrivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. So to begin with, I would like to seek the blessings of Maharaj and senior devotees so that we can discuss about this Srimad Bhagavatam, where very sweet pastimes are going on now of Mother Yashoda binding Lord Krishna in the sweet service of marathon, which Prabhupada has mercifully given us. So here, now this is the end of this chapter. Mother Yashoda binds Lord Krishna. So two more verses are there, and then the chapter ends. Yesterday also we were seeing that how very sweetly we are hearing the pastimes of the greatness of Mother Yashoda. So the devotees are in great ecstasy when they are glorifying devotees in connection with Krishna. So that is the sign of devotee, that they become ecstatic just by glorifying Krishna through their devotees. And we see this practically everywhere. Whenever the Lord is glorified, Lord is always glorified in connection with devotees. If you take the seventh canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, which the whole topic is Narasimhadev, and if you see the seventh canto is quite big, but then the appearance of Narasimhadev and then dealings and pastime of Narasimhadev is covered in just one chapter, that he just comes and before the whole thing, after the whole thing, it's just a glories of Prahlad Maharaj, that how Prahlad Maharaj was so glorious in doing devotional service. So we see that when Shukadeva Goswami is talking about Prahlad Maharaj, he is so much in ecstasy. And when we find in the canto, first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, when the Bhishma Dev, he is glorifying Krishna lying on the bed of arrows, he becomes very pleased in great ecstasy, although he is about to die. This is the time when he was lying down on the bed of arrows. Bhagavad Gita was spoken on Vaikuntha Ekadashi, and then after that 18 days fight was there, and ahead of that then he was lying down for months waiting for Krishna to appear. And when Krishna appeared, he started glorifying him. But if you see the glorification of his in first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, he glorifies Krishna in connection with his affection to Pandavas. He says, Pandavas are so great that they were protected by you. Pandavas are so nice. You love them so much. Because he knew that if Pandavas are glorified, then Krishna will be automatically be happy. So here also we are finding that the glory of Mother Yashoda is extolled by Shukadeva Goswami. And as yesterday also we are seeing that even Shukadeva Goswami is in great ecstasy talking about Mother Yashoda. Because that is the way the Yashoda means one who gives fame. So this pastime specifically of Mother Yashoda binds Lord Krishna, this increases the fame of the Lord. And who increases that is Mother Yashoda. So in this whole pastime, Bhrutya Vatsata, as yesterday we were seeing, Bhrutya Vashyata means one who is under Vasha or under the control of his devotees. So this is a very unique quality of Krishna, that Krishna loves his devotees so much that he becomes subordinate to his devotees. So that is that quality of Krishna attracts the heart of devotees. In this world we find that those who are in the position of controllers, in the position of boss, they never become so happy that they will be controlled by their subordinate, because that is considered, and that's, they are boss not to become subordinate. In this world, nobody wants to become boss and then become subordinate. Rather, they want to, you know, rise higher. And that pastime is there where Prabhupada was talking about book publication, and he was talking to the, I think, Dainippan, the officers, they were there, and then they were discussing about the different possibilities and the details of publication of Bhagavad Gita. After everybody goes, one of the employee of that stayed back having conversation with Prabhupada. And Prabhupada, we can see that he took every opportunity to preach. Whether he is a CEO of company, whether he is a government official, whether he is even a simple employee. What to speak of somebody like hippie also. So for him, even when the some reporters coming to ask and take some interview, you'll find that Prabhupada will speak as if he is speaking to that reporter only. Now the object of his speaking is this reporter, and that this reporter should take to Krishna consciousness. Like that he will speak. Reporter will ask that, you know, we have seen that your society is, like here it was asked, that your society is only for rich people. So Prabhupada is telling him that, no, where we have written like that on our board, that it is for everybody, you also can come. So that reporter said that, no, but I am happy in my life. So that is one of the kind of people give excuse, that who goes to temple? Those who are in need. Those who are kind of, either they are poor or they are very suffering, and then they can go to temple. So he was giving the answer that, I am happy, but why I need to go to temple? So Prabhupada very mercifully told him that was big dose of mercy, because it was Indian scenario and he was also Indian, he couldn't understand. And this conversation was going on in Hindi, so Prabhupada said, Dhobi ka gadha bhi khush hota hai. Everybody is khush only. But that doesn't mean that is the highest. So he said that the highest is serving Krishna, and by that you become actually happy. So we see that the devotees specifically, they are very eager to glorify Krishna in connection with Krishna's devotees, in connection with Krishna. So here Prabhupada says in Srimad Bhagavatam that the devotional service actually starts with Dasya Ras. And then Prabhupada quotes this, Ye yatha mam prapadyante tams tathaiva bhajamyaham mama vartmanu vartante manushyah partha sarvashah. That everybody is wanting to follow Krishna. So the way we were discussing about this Prabhupada's pastime, where he was talking to this one of the employee. So Prabhupada asked him, what is the goal of your life? So he was quite expressive. So he didn't speak, but then because the meeting had just ended, all the cards were there of each participant. So he collected all the cards in the round table and then he put it, and then he put his card on the top and he looked at Prabhupada, telling that this is the goal of my life, that this I want to become the boss in this company. So generally the tendency of every living entity is to become boss. Nobody likes to be das. So only devotees are excited when they get das title. Outside, Prabhuji is telling only name. So, yeah, but then we can see that the parampara offers us this, that parampara offers a great privilege to become das. And as Prabhupada is quoting here, e yatha mam prapadyante, that everybody follows the path of Krishna, or everybody is wanting Krishna, everybody wants to love Krishna. So here Krishna is telling, mama vartmanu vartante manushaha partha sarvashaha, that everybody follows my path. So what it means? Sarva means everybody. Everybody means devotees, karmis, jnanis, yogis, non-devotees, atheists. Everybody follows whose path? Krishna's path. So how can you say like that? So the thing is, path is one only. Here is Krishna, here is living entity. Path is one. Some are going towards Krishna, some are going away from Krishna. Path is one only. So those who are looking towards Krishna, wanting to serve him, they are exactly going towards Krishna. And others, they are going away from Krishna. But then, they are going away from Krishna to where? Because there can be nothing in this world which can attract. Because only Krishna has the capacity to attract. That's why his name is Krishna. So wherever there is a shadow of Krishna's opulence in this world, they will be attracted and going towards that. We find that they don't want to be attractive to the most supremely beautiful Krishna. They say, no, we don't want to be attracted to Krishna. But then they will be attracted to the shadow of one small fraction of that beauty in this world. To some, you know, nature's beauty, or some man's beauty, women's beauty, or so they are attracted to that, which is just a spark of Krishna's beauty. It's a, so in one sense they are attracted to Krishna only, because material nature has no power to attract living entities on her own. So in this sense, everybody follows the path of Krishna. Everybody wants to achieve Krishna. And how can we understand that everybody is part and parcel of Krishna? Prabhupada writes so beautifully in a small book, Teachings of Prahlad Maharaj. It's a very small booklet. But then it is very powerful. Prabhupada gives one very nice example, that to know that everybody has innate understanding that I am part and parcel of Krishna. Some accept, some don't. Some are vehemently opposed to it. That doesn't change their situation. And then Prabhupada gives that why everybody wants to save themselves. The law, first law in this world is self-preservation. That everybody wants to safeguard. And that you don't have to teach. Birds, they do it. Animals, they do it. Humans, they do it. Even a small, you know, baby does it without, you know, going to school or wherever there is a danger, they want to save, guard themselves. That is not to be taught. So Prabhupada goes to that thing and tells that how that nature of safeguarding ourselves has come. He doesn't know that here is a danger, I'll die, but then he runs away from it. He doesn't know also what is death. He doesn't know what is life, but still he wants to safeguard. So he says, why he wants to safeguard? He is not like realize that I am soul and I am... He has no idea of that, but still he wants to safeguard. He says, because naturally everybody loves Krishna. Jai Shri Radharas Bihari Ji Ki, Shri Shri Sitaram Lakshman Hanuman Ki, Shri Shri Konitai Ki, Srila Prabhupada Ki. So, we find that Prabhupada gives this example. He says that a small child who is just few months old and is very crying. And we see that such crying child, very difficult to pacify. You do whatever, it's like the volume doesn't become paused. But then Prabhupada mentions there that when the child is taken to the lap of mother, just by the touch of that lap of his mother, he quiets. He feels now no more crying. So Prabhupada says there that the child doesn't know what is mother. Child doesn't know that here is mother. Child doesn't know that here I am more safe. That understanding is not there. Still he feels very pacified. He feels sheltered. So Prabhupada says, how? Because the child has come from the womb of that mother. There is an innate connection with that mother and that child. So whenever that child is put into connection with that same mother who is the source, he feels very satisfied, even without knowing that this is my mother. Similarly, Prabhupada says that whenever somebody comes in touch with Krishna in any way, we have seen it also. Here, people, they come to temple. Just by entering temple, they feel very pacified. Just by being here. So that shows that everybody is part and parcel of Krishna. That you come in touch with Krishna, you become pacified. And specifically this we can see that how everybody is part and parcel of Krishna and they want to serve Krishna, whatever they may say. Because we are distributing books in now rural areas near Nasik, Kopargaon. So we are going with the van to interior parts and distributing books. So just 4 days back we are going. So we went to one company owner, small scale company. We showed the books. So that company owner was sitting with his friend and he said that nahi, time nahi hai. You see, this lockdown is just opening and things like that. So he said, so we were like pursuing. So he took out his 100 rupees just to kind of end the business and put on the table. He said that you take this. Bhagavad Gita nahi chahiye. So other person, he was telling that actually, you know, I am atheist. He said, I don't believe in this. But he said, because all of you have come, so he also took 100 rupees and gave. So I was thinking that India's culture is such that even atheist gives 100 rupees donation when he sees devotees. And What to speak of this? This atheist person, he started telling about his devotee friend who is chanting 16 rounds in that same community, which the devotee was not kind of, we had never met him. Although he was just staying close to our choice, 2 minutes walk, but we never met him. And chanting 16 rounds, he was looking for devotees, like that. So he told that your person is there here. So he said that, I cannot do, but he will help you. Like that. So then we met that devotee, he was very happy. We were also very happy. So next day, to take his help, we went that, can you please help us? We'll go to different people here in MIDC. He said, the person who told you is very nice. He speaks very nice. We'll take him only. Atheist personally. So he called him. He said, we are going to some companies. Can you come? He said, okay. So next day, he was part of our team of collecting Vidyadhan. And then we were going from place to place. And he was speaking the maximum, telling that, see, I cannot practice Krishna consciousness. You also cannot practice because you don't have time. But these people are good. Better you give. And he was convincing everybody. So I was thinking that, what an amazing atheist we have. because the culture is so, and specifically I could see that whenever they come in touch with Prabhupada's books, you can see this magic everywhere. And this magic is seen 50 years back, magic is seen now, and magic will be seen next 10,000 years. So once one person was asked, he was asking to one devotee, that he said that, do you believe in magic? Devotees believe in magic. So that devotee was telling him, we don't believe in magic, we live magic. Our life is whole magic only. So that magic can be seen in Prabhupada's book distribution. Wherever we give out this transcendental literature, which Prabhupada has given so mercifully, then we see that people's life are transformed visibly. And that transforms us also. Because although we are reading it, distributing it, but when we see the effect in others, that gives so much faith to practice one's own Krishna consciousness very firmly. So, this month is very auspicious by distribution of Prabhupada's literature. And as last time also we were discussing that, live to give, because by giving we live, by giving we also get the benefit. That's why they say that those hands who pass the roses, they don't have to put a saint specifically, because they are left fragrant just by passing on the flowers. So similarly, when we are passing on this message of Lord Krishna in the form of Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, without any doubt, we will also gain supreme benediction of devotional service. So when we are seeing this pastimes of Krishna, we see that devotee, they overpower Krishna with their love. And with these two last verses we'll end. So that the text 22, Krishnastu Gruha Kriteshu Vyagraya Matari Prabhu Adrakshidarjuno Purvam Gushyakau Dhanadatmajau. While Mother Yashoda was very busy with household affairs, the Supreme Lord Krishna observed twin trees known as Yamalarjuna, which in a former millennium had been the demigod's son of Kuvera. Puranarada shapena vrikshatam prapitau madat nalakuvera manigriva iti akhyato shriyanvitau. In their former birth, these two sons, known as Nalakuvera and Manigriva, were extremely opulent and fortunate. But because of pride and false prestige, they did not care about anyone. And thus Narada Muni cursed them to become trees. So there is another very wonderful pastime, comes here, that how Krishna delivers these twin trees, very powerful, tall Arjuna trees. And we can see here that whatever Krishna sees, here the description comes that Krishna saw the Yamala Arjuna trees. And seeing trees, whom he remembered? He remembered Narada Muni. So that is how the Krishna is. The devotees, whatever they see around, they remember Krishna. And whatever Krishna sees around, he remembers devotees. That's the way the Krishna's consciousness is. Krishna consciousness. So Krishna consciousness is, he thinks of devotees like that. So although he is looking at trees, he is remembering Narada Muni. And then he is reminded that I have to do something because Narada has cursed them. So I have to deliver. So we see that here also we find that Krishna's activities are to give pleasure to devotees. So that's how he becomes always bound. It is not only when he is bound only with the rope of Mother Yashoda. With the words of his pure devotee, he is always bound. If the pure devotees, they say something, he becomes subordinate to that. Whether it is Kaunteya Pratijani hi name bhakta pranashyati, he is telling that you, Arjuna, go out and tell others that my devotees never perish. Why he is telling Arjuna? Because Krishna takes this most seriously, and that is the words of his own devotees. He cannot cross it. And in 7th canto also we find that because it was word of Prahlad Maharaj, Brahma and others, Krishna appeared even through the stone. He appeared from the pillar because it was his devotee has told that yes, Krishna is here. So we see that Krishna becomes bound by the love of his devotees, so much so that whatever the devotees say, then one is bound by that. So one example of this, that while book distribution, the devotees had come back and then they were so happy, Prabhupada was there. So then they asked Prabhupada that, Prabhupada, if somebody dies doing marathon while distributing books, will he go back home, back to Godhead? So they were expecting that Prabhupada will say yes. But then Prabhupada's answer kind of put them in fix. Prabhupada said, yeah, if they are thinking of Krishna, he will surely go. If he not, then... So devotees were looking little kind of perplexed. So seeing the perplexity of devotees, Prabhupada said, but I can tell you, if devotees distribute books till end of their life, then in whatever situation they die, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will personally come to pick them up at the time of death. So devotees were very happy. Jai Prabhupada, they said. Prabhupada ki. Srila Prabhupada, Transcendental Book Distribution Marathon ki. Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Hare Krishna. So we'll end here.